गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर डिस्कस अबाउट एटम्स। इट्स अ वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक स्टूडेंट्स, एटम्स। एक्चुअली वी नो इन एटम्स वन 8 मार्क्स क्वेश्चन प्लस वन 4 प्लस वन 2 मार्क्स क्वेश्चन। फ्रॉम दिस टॉपिक 6 आर 10 marks. Friends, from this topic, 6 or 10 marks for AP, Intermediate Public Exam. For competitive exam, okay, 2 questions are given in competitive exam, but in MCET is 2 marks. But in JEE mains, 2 into 4, 8 marks. So this is very very useful for competitive exams and also useful for IP examination. Actually in atoms, 3 important models are there. One is Thomson atomic model and second one is Rutherford atomic model. Third one is Bohr's atomic model. We know that Thomson atomic model, okay, in Thomson atomic model, Thomson atomic model. Students, the total positive charge of atom, the total positive charge of atom uniformly distributed all over the atom. The total positive charge uniformly distributed all over the atom. The negative charges are like electrons embedded in it. The negative charge like electrons embedded in it, like seeds in watermelon. So this model is also called plum and pudding model. Students, according to Thomson model, the first statement is the total positive charge uniformly distributed all over the atom. The negative charge like electrons embedded in it. It is seals in watermelon. So this model is called plum and pudding model. Then second statement is, okay, every atom is neutral because the total negative charge or positive charge of atom is equal to negative charge. So that atom is always neutral. But in Thomson atomic model, okay, then 2 drawbacks are there. Students, 2 drawbacks are there. One is, okay, it could not explain, students, it is common dialogue, it could not explain stability of atom. This is one. Then second one, students, it could not explain stability of atom. It could not explain spectra of atom. Students, if you produce the spectra, the electron must be jump from higher energy to lower to higher. So in this model, electrons not jump from higher to lower, so that cannot explain spectra of atom. So third one, it could not explain large scattered alpha particles. Okay, large scattered alpha particles. This is for large scattered alpha particles. In Rutherford alpha scattering experiment, then explain. So this is Thomson atomic model. Simple students, the total positive charge uniformly distributed all over the atom. The negative charges embedded in it like seeds in watermelon. This model is called plum and pudding model. This is first statement. Second statement, atom is always neutral. Okay, the total positive charge of atom equal to negative charge of atom. Okay, how many drawbacks are there? 3. It could not explain stability of atom, spectra of atom, and it could not explain large scattered alpha particle. So this is Thomson model. This is most important 4 marks topic. Okay, next Rutherford atomic model. Students, second one is Rutherford atomic model. Atomic model. Okay. First statement of Rutherford atomic model, the total positive charge, students. This is the total positive charge to be concentrated in center at small space. So it is called nuclei. It is called nucleus. Simple students. So the total positive charge to be concentrated center, to be concentrated center. The total positive charge to be concentrated center, it is called nucleus in small space. Small space. Okay. Next, second one. And electrons revolve around the nuclei. And electrons revolve around the nuclei like planets revolve around the sun. So, an electron revolves around the nuclei like planets revolve around the sun. Suppose, for example, electrons revolve around the nuclei. This is electrons revolve around the nuclei like planets revolve around the sun. Students, third one is, this is first statement, very simple. The total positive charge to be concentrated in center in small space is called nucleus. Second one is very easy. And electrons, the negative charged electrons revolve around the nuclei like planet revolve around the sun. Third one, atoms are neutral. The total positive charge of atom is equal to negative charge of atom. Okay, fourth one, of atom is empty. The most of the atom is empty because the total positive charge concentrated in small space. So that empty. The most of the atom is empty. We know that every person, the nucleus is, size of nucleus is 10 to the power of minus 15 meters. Size of atom is 10 to the power of minus 10 meters. Four statements. First one is very simple. The total positive charge concentrated center in small space, it is called a nucleus. Second point, the negative charge like electrons revolve around the nucleus like planets revolve around the sun. Okay, atoms are always neutral. The total positive charge of atom equal to negative charge of atom. Most of the atom is empty due to the total positive charge concentrated in small space. Size of nuclei is 10 to the power of minus 15 meter. Size of atom is 10 to the power of minus 10 meters. Okay, what are the drawbacks of Rutherford atomic model? Students, this is very, very important. Drawbacks of Rutherford atomic model. This is most important 2 marks question for AP examination. First one, it could not explain stability of atom. Same students, it could not explain stability of atom. Simple. Suppose, for example, an electron revolves around the nucleus continuously, radiates some energy. After some time, electrons falls inside of the nucleus, so the atom will be collapsed. But atom is not collapsed, so it could not explain stability of atom. Second one, it could not explain spectra of atom. Spectra of atom, students. This is two drawbacks. It is very, very important to mark's question. It could not explain stability of atom. It could not explain spectra of atom. This is Rutherford atomic model. So, students, after completion of Rutherford atomic model, next, now discuss about Bohr's atomic model. Third one is Bohr's atomic model. Bohr's atomic model. Students, this is very, very important 8 marks topic in IP examination. First of all, in Bohr's atomic model, postulate 1. First postulate. An electrons revolve around the nuclei. And electrons, revolve around the nuclei in stationary or stable orbits. In stationary or stable orbits. So, what is the meaning of stationary or stable orbits? An electrons does not radiate in the energy. An electrons does not radiate in the energy. Does not radiate the energy. It's also no problem. This is first postulate of Bohr atomic model. Simple, students. An electrons revolve around the nuclei in stationary or stable orbits. Okay, in this situation, the between nuclei and electron, electrostatic force is there. This electrostatic force and the electron revolve around the nuclei with radius r. Okay, the charge of nuclei is ZeE. The charge of electron is Q2 is equal to E. The electrostatic force is 1 by 4 pi epsilon 1 according to Coulomb's inverse square law, Q1 into Q2 by R square. Q1 means ZeE into E by R square. It is equal to centripetal force. We know that student centripetal force formula mv square by R. According to postulate 1, this is the most important formula. 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught ZE into E by R square is equal to mv square by R. Next, postulate 2, students, second postulate. Okay, an angular momentum of electron. Students, an angular momentum of electron in stationary orbit is equal to integral multiple of h by 2 pi. Angular momentum formula, we know that students, mvr is equal to nh by 2 pi. Okay, n gives 1 comma 2 comma 3 comma del dash. Students, h cut is equal to, we know that every person, h by 2 pi. This is very very important for JEE or MCQ examination. How is the value of h cut, h by 2 pi? Friends, the second postulate is very easy. An angular momentum of electron in stationary orbit is equal to integral multiple of h by 2 pi. Okay, postulate 3. Friends, third postulate. An electron jumps from an higher energy state to lower energy state. An electron jumps from higher energy state to lower energy state. Okay, and then evolve some energy or radiate some energy. That energy is photon energy h mu. It is equal to difference of energy levels. So E2 minus E1 is equal to h mu. This is the postulate 3. An electron jump from higher energy state to lower energy state, some of the energy is radiated, that is photon energy h mu is equal to difference of two energy levels, E2 minus E1. This is three postulates of Bohr. Okay, now discuss about radius of orbit. Student, now discuss about radius of orbit. Radius of orbit. Okay, students, radius of orbit. From postulate 1, students, from postulate 1, we know that centripetal force mv square by r is equal 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, okay, e square by r square. This is actual, we know that electrostatic force. For hydrogen atom, z is equal to 1. Student, square and r are cancel. So what? Mv square is equal to e square by 4 pi epsilon naught into R. This is the mv square equation 1. Student, from postulate 2. Students, from postulate 2. Mvr is equal to nh by 2 pi. That implies, students, v is equal to nh by 2 pi mr. This square value, v square value, v square is equal to n square h square by 4 pi square m square r square. This value substitute in equation 1. Students, 1 implies m into v square n square h square by 4 pi square m square r square is equal to E square by 4 pi epsilon naught into R. Students, 4 cancel, square pi cancel, square R cancel, M square cancel. After cross multiplication, students, n square, h square, epsilon naught is equal to pi m e square into r. Pi m e square into r. Students, r is equal to n square, h square, epsilon naught by pi m e square. This is the radius of the orbit. Students, for nth orbit, all the values are substituted in this equation. Nth orbit radius Rn is equal to 0.53 n square angstroms. This is the radius of the nth orbit. Students, it's very simple. First thing one, an electron revolves around the nucleus in stable orbit or stationary orbit. Okay, an angular momentum of electron, integral multiple of h by 2 pi, second question. An electron jump from higher energy state to lower energy state. Okay, some of the energy is radiated, that is photon energy, h mu is equal difference of two energy levels. This is three postulates. A radius of orbit from postulate 1 states, okay, mv square by r is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into e square by r square, because z is equal to 1 for hydrogen atom. Square and r cancel, students. Okay, mv square is equal to e square by 4 pi epsilon naught r, equation 1. From postulate 2, mvr is equal to nh by 2 pi, but v is equal to nh by 2 pi mr. Students, square both sides. V square is equal to n square, h square, 4 pi square, m square, r square. This value substitute in equation 1. After simplification, r is equal to n square, h square, epsilon naught by pi m e square. All the values are substituted in this equation. The radius of the nth orbit, 0.53 n square angstroms. Okay. Which is the next one?